Dear students, welcome to session 3 of chapter number 3, Working with Functions.
So we have already seen that how the parameters, positional parameters are passed into a function. Okay, in the last session we've done this. Now we'll be looking at how we are going to pass the parameters with default arguments and what are keyword or named parameters. So let's see them one by one. So first thing is default parameters. As the name says, that these parameters have some default value during the time of definition of the function itself. So default values are provided to the parameters. And what happens here, let's see with an example only. We have made a function with the name interest over here, and we have passed three arguments into the function, p, t and r, and r has a default value as 0.10. So what we are going to do, let's suppose I am calling this function in my main program, si equals to interest, and with two parameters I have called the function. Okay, so this means what? As the positional parameters say, according to the position, the first value is passed to p and the second value is passed to t. But there is no value for r. That means at this point of time, r will have the value of 0.10. So the interest will be calculated with p as 10,000, t as 2 and r as 0.10 in this case, in the first case. Right? Now, if I again want to call this function interest, okay, with three values this time. So the first value, that is 10,500, will be copied to p, 2 will be copied to t, and 0.08 is going to be copied to r. That means what? If the parameter is missing, so it is going to take the default value, okay, which is given there in the definition of the function. And if the parameter is there, if the value is already passed as the actual argument, then the default value will be overridden. R will now have the value 0.08 in this calling of the function, and here R will have the value 0.10. Got that? Now, one more thing, very important thing is that until and unless we don't provide the value to R here, okay, I'm taking this example only, unless and until I not give the value to R, I cannot provide the value to t or p as default values I'm talking about. Okay, so if I want to provide a default value to t, so all its rightmost parameters, whatsoever rightmost parameters are there, they also must be provided with some value. Right, if I want to provide a default value to p, that means t and r also must be provided with some default value. You can see here, def interest p, t equals to 5 and r. Here, I have not given a value to r. Okay. So, this definition of the function is actually wrong, because the value of r must be given first, and then only we can give the value to t. So, this is a syntax error. So this is correct. R also has a value and t also has a default value here. Okay. In the next one, keyword or named arguments. What happens if we provide names to our arguments and we call the argument with that name itself? Okay, so that is actually your named arguments. What is the benefit of using named arguments in our program? The benefit is, like till now we have to keep a track of the positions of our arguments. That means the first value will be given to the first argument, okay, the second value will be given to the second argument, and third value is given to the third argument. But now with named arguments, we can keep any order of our arguments while calling. So you can see here, like def sum ABC, okay, x is having the value A, y gets the value of B, and Z gets the value of C, and then some calculation is provided, and then we have printed it. Now in the main program, I have called this function sum with C having the value 5, A has the value 2, and B has the value 10. So that means C is this one, value 5. A gets the value 2 and B gets the value 10. Now, the values are not passed by the positions. Rather, the value will be given according to the names of the variables. So, we have just changed the order of our argument list over here because we have called the arguments with their names. Now, if I am saying x has the value of a, so a has the value 2, right? So, if I am saying x into 2, x is what? A. So, x is, a is 2. So, 2 into 2. Understood? Next time, y is b. Y into 3 is done here. So, y is b. B is 10. So, 10 into 3. Similarly, z has the value of c. And c is 5. Z into 4. So, 5 into 4. This is how the calculations will be performed. And finally, the output has come. Okay? Okay. Now, if we want to use a mixture of all these three types of argument passing, like we have studied about what all types of ways of passing parameters, positional parameters were there, then we had default arguments, and then we have keyword or name parameters, right? So, if we want to use all three of them together or any combination together, that also is possible. Like you can see here, def interest, print cc, time equals to 2, rate equals to 0.09. So, these are the arguments with default values. Now, while calling of this function interest in the main program, from the main program, or any other function, interest print equals to 3000 and cc equals to 5. So, what is done here? We have called the keyword parameters. Print has the value 3000 and cc has the value 5, and rest arguments are not there. So, that means default arguments are taken over here. So, this calling is absolutely legal. In the next case, interest rate has the value 0.12. So, now the value of rate is changed here. Print also has the value 5000 and cc has the value 4. So, again the named arguments are called here. And then because time is not given, so time will have the value 2. So, again this is a legal statement. In the next case, now we are just passing the values and we are not saying whose value is this. So, that means positional arguments are used here. So, 10,000 will be copied to print and 3 will be copied to CC, and rate has the value 0.08. So, time will remain 2. Again, this is a legal statement. Now, you check for the last one. Rate has the value 0.05. The value is changed. And then we have used 5003. So, whom to give these values? Because now the positions are changed. So, CC can have this value and 3. Time can be 3. So, where the value of print will be, right? So, this time your statement is wrong. So, either we'll be using positional arguments and then we can use the default arguments or the named arguments. We have to keep a check that the statements must be correct. We can use all three kinds together, but the statements must be correct. Okay. Now, calculation of SI with default arguments. Okay, let's see. One program is made over here. Def, interest, P, T and R are given the value as 2 and 0.10 respectively. Okay, these are the default values given to T and R. Return P into R into T. So, we have just returned these values. Now, what happened in the main program? P gets the value from the user. SI, interest, P. So, just one value is passed. The actual argument is passed over here as P. And T and R are not there. They are missing from here. That means we will be taking the values of T and R from the default values only. From the default arguments only. Okay. And print SI. That means let's suppose if the user has given the value as 5000. So, P will hold the value 5000, T as 2 and R as 0.10, and the interest will be calculated accordingly. Now, in the next case, I have passed the value of P which is given by the user, and then I have given the values for T and R respectively over here. Okay, now my t will be 3 and r will be 0.07. Okay, the values which were default are overwritten here. Okay, and thus the SI will be calculated and printed. In the next case, again I have taken the values of t and r from the user itself, and now I have calculated SI, and thus these three values, the values which are provided by the user, are used here, and finally SI is calculated, interest is calculated. So all three cases together in one program are shown here. Now in the next thing, returning values from a function. Now when we call a function, the function may return a value or it may not return a value. So a function that returns a value is actually a non-void function. It is called a non-void function. Okay, and all non-void function must have a return statement into it, right? They should have return statement into it. That is means this is the way they are going to return a single or multiple values from their functions, right? Now the functions that does not return a value, okay, there may be function which are just used to which actually does the calculation in itself only and print everything there itself. So they need not return a value. So the functions that does not return a value, they are actually void functions. The ones who returns the value are non-void, and the ones who returns does not return a value, they are void functions. And these void functions may or may not have a return statement in them. Now we can just see about the non-void function. The non-void function, what all type of values they can return? The values can be literals, like return 0. So they are returning a constant value, so they can return a literal. Similarly, they can return a variable, as we have already done many a times, return x. So whatever the value of x will be, that will be returned here. And return an expression. So return a into b plus c into d. So this is an expression. So this also can be returned. But the thing is, whatever they are returning, finally, they all calculate themselves as a value only. X should have one value. A into b plus c into d should have one single value. So this is what they return. They can return with three types, but they are actually returning a constant value only. Okay. Now, when a non-void function returns a value, how the caller function, means the function that is getting that value, how that function should take the value from the function itself. You can see here, def mult ab return a into b, right? Now, what happens when I'm returning some value from a function? This value must be held by some variable. Okay, like m is equals to mult 3, 4. Okay, a gets the value 3, b gets the value 4. So 3 into 4 is 12. So m is 12. It is returning 12. And where this 12 will be stored? 12 will be stored in m. Right? Or otherwise, the other method can be, I'm just printing this value. Print mult 3, 4. I have called mult function here. So this is going to return 12. So print 12. So again, it is going to print 12. Here, m gets the value 12. Here, 12 will be printed. And now here, in this section, you can see there is an expression given here. So this return, the value that is returned can be used in expression also. Mult 3, 4 will return 12. 12 greater than 10. So this is an expression. So the returned value should either go, always either be saved into some variable, it should be in some print statement, or it can be in an expression. Okay, so three ways how we return our values. Now the last topic is returning multiple values. Now Python is just, I think it is just one language where we can return multiple values from a function. Otherwise, in all the languages, we can return just single value from a function. So how these multiple values are tackled? Just see over here. Def squared is the name of the function, x, y, and z. three parameters are passed here, and this is the expression that is returning. Okay, x square, y square, and z square. Now, either see three things are passed, three things are returned, three values are returned over here, x square, y square, and z square. So there should be either a tuple to hold these three values, or there can be we can unpack the tuple and get the value over here. So t equals to square 2, 3, 4. So it is going to return 4, 3, 3 is 9, and 16. Right, so 4, 9, and 16, t will become a tuple over here. Print t, it will print the tuple. So either the returned values, if many values are returned, they can either be stored in the form of a tuple, or maybe possible if we want to take the values one by one. So we are returning three values here, so there should be three variables to hold these three values. So x square will go into a, y square will go into b, and z square will go into c. So you can see the output, print a, b, c. So 4, 9 and 16 are printed. Is this clear? So with this, we come to the end of this session. Thank you.